am Samantha Bee. Welcome to Full Frontal. Ooh, what a fun time to be alive.
Absolutely explosive news out of Washington tonight.
The city erupting at the news.
The bombshell announcement. It is seismic. It's bizarre and it's an earthquake.
It is so outrageous. It is so grotesque. It is so wrong.
This is shocking.
Shocked would be a gross understatement.
This is a crisis for the country.
The shockwaves will ripple out here.
Ooh, a shockwave bombshell earthquake. Oh, how I pity anyone in the DC area who was baking a souffle when the news broke. I'm so sorry for your loss, Lindsey Graham. This brings us to our recurring segment, our weekly constitutional crisis. What the f*** is it this time? Yesterday afternoon, the only FBI drama most Americans expected to unfold on TV were the upcoming seasons of Twin Peaks and The X-Files. But at 6 p.m., with our show written and the staff on their second whiskey, our dumb democracy ran into a wall with a bucket on its head again.
I was on the way to winning until the combination of Jim Comey's letter on October 28th and Russian WikiLeaks raised doubts in the minds of people.
This is CNN Breaking News.
All right, we have major breaking news. We're interrupting that report. Jeff Zeleny, our White House, senior White House correspondent, is joining us on the future of the FBI director.
The president of the United States has terminated the director of the FBI, James Comey.
Ah, Comey managed to get in Hillary's way one last time, for old time's sake. Thus began the slow motion clusterfuck of impulsiveness and ineptitude that this White House is famous for. Trump had his bodyguard take a dismissal letter, complete with a totally normal digression about how the president didn't collude with Russia, okay, and hand deliver it straight to FBI headquarters, where Comey wasn't. He was in Los Angeles, where he learned about his firing from a TV report, got in an SUV, and was slowly followed down the highway in a weird echo of the OJ chase, except not really, because we know the president would never have fired his good friend the Juice. Then Sean Spicer managed the narrative by hiding in the bushes so reporters wouldn't film him because he'd rather get Lyme disease than talk to the press. And the cable news networks flipped out for 6 hours without a single commercial break, which means Americans spent the whole evening not knowing who to call about our mesothelioma or what pill to take for opioid-induced constipation.
Tried prunes, laxatives, still constipated. Had to talk to my doctor. She said, how long you been holding this in?
And what the hell am I supposed to do with all my old gold? They say those who forget history are doomed to repeat it. But last night, those who remembered history also got pretty repetitive.
It's October 20th, 1973, the Saturday Night Massacre, when Richard Nixon fired Archibald Cox, the special prosecutor.
Perhaps worse than October 20th, 1973.
Most tainted actions by President Nixon.
Hot on his tail on Watergate.
The shades of Nixon.
The Watergate break-in.
The Saturday Night Massacre.
It looks like he's pulled a Saturday Night Live massacre.
Wasn't that the working title for Studio 60 on the Sunset Strip? By 7:30, and I am not making this up, the staff of Nixon's official library were trying to wash the Donald Trump taint off Richard Nixon with the hashtag #NotNixonian, which is fair. At least Nixon wasn't at war with late night comedy.
Suck it to me.
You know what? Fine, guys. Trump doesn't want to be associated with you either. Wait, oh my God, are you f-ing kidding me?
Where did Henry Kissinger come from? Why was he at the White House at this very moment?
He never left. He's been trapped in the dumbwaiter all these years. Ooh, I can't wait for R. Kelly to write a hip hopera about this. And while you're at it, R., get Trump to release his pee tape. Reached for comment inside the Large Hadron Collider, Vladimir Putin said this.
President Trump is acting in accordance with his competence.
We know. That's the problem. His only competence is firing people, and he's too dumb to understand why this time his ratings didn't go up.
I was told by earlier tonight by a source familiar with discussions inside the White House that they did not expect this to be the political explosion that it was.
Newsflash! Most of us love our democratic norms more than we hate the other team, President Ding Dong. This isn't partisan. I don't like James Comey? Nobody does. You either think he lost Hillary the election, or you think he's the reason she's not locked up. Comey's a bit of a turd. But at least he's an independent turd. Whoever Trump appoints next to lead the FBI, whether it's David Clark, Joe Arpaio, or Ivanka in a trench coat, they'll know that if they look too hard at Trump's Russia connections, they'll be out. That's why Jeffrey Toobin's job last night was to appear on every single show and say one thing over and over.
This is not normal. This is not normal. I do know that this is not normal. This is not a normal event in American history. It's not normal, and it's not American. It's not normal. This is not how presidents behave.
Jeff Toobin, I gotta start with you. Is this normal?
No.
I guess we'll never know. Except this has become normal. This president has wiped his ass with the Constitution so many times, the National Archives started leaving passive-aggressive notes asking him to chip in for toilet paper. When POTUS shot off an insulting, infantile tweet during Hannity's show, as usual, we were just relieved it wasn't a whole tweet storm. Just one tweet? Gosh, that's practically presidential. That's where we are. The president is meeting with a war criminal, Putin's playing space hockey, and the press secretary is hiding in some shrubbery. Did I miss anything?
We didn't get the chance to say it. This is day 110 of the Trump administration.
Oh, God. Sean, scoot over. We'll be right back.